All right, this is what I come up with. I used a piece of chalk to mark my line. And I'm just gonna try to cut it on the table saw. Hopefully the best. I don't know what else I can do. I'm gonna try to line it up and go for it. Well, let's hope I never have to do that again. Sucky.
All right. This is where we're at so far. Got the roof on. Have one side, actually two sides on. This way you can put the back on before we put it in place, because I didn't want to be able to slide that thing. It'd be too heavy. Anyway, we got the front left. Put some doors on it. And then we're going to put a ramp down from the opening into this coop so they can find their way in there. And then we're going to rebuild the run and make it go all the way over. So it'll include the underneath and then all the way across and then out. So it'll be substantially larger. All right. So just another update. Finally got all the coverings on and just added a little. This is the door, so we can clean it out. But yeah, I'm gonna put a bunch of trim on it to pretty it up before we paint it. But for all intents and purposes, I'm pretty much done with the coop part. The next piece will be to transition this into the old system and get rid of that. So we're gonna build some two by threes and extend this up to there. And then cage it all in so that they have the whole entire space to run back and forth. Anyway, that's the current status. So the way this turned out over here with the box, so I'm gonna leave this as netting up there for airflow. And then this will be the box where you lay this box. And that's it. Should be a lot better for them. So probably post another update when we're doing the trim, because we'll put trim, you know, around all the edges and around the door and stuff to just kind of make it look a little more fancy. And we'll paint it. We're gonna paint the coop red and then we'll paint the trim white so it looks kind of like a barn. I think that'll be kind of fun. Anyway, that's it. All right, so we're moving on. We're pretty much done with the coop for now. We're gonna do some trim and paint it later, but now we've gotta build the side that we're gonna basically build out the cage part of it. And so what I've opted, went and measured, and I'm where I'm at right now, and I'm not gonna move it. The edge of the coop is 13 feet from the wall, so I'm basically gonna build it, just frame it all out, just using these 2x3s that I'm using for all of this stuff. And the wire that I have is 36 inches wide, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do, instead of doing 16 centers, I'm gonna do 36 so that my wire will line up. I don't need to do anything stronger than that because there won't be any weight on this. It will literally just be supporting itself. So there's not going to be an issue with structural integrity. One thing that you do want to note when you're doing these is that if you measure your 36, remember that that's going to be your center mark. So like we did in the other video, you want to go 3/4 on both sides to mark your stud. So we're just framing this out like we did the walls, and then we'll run the material over it, the netting, the chicken wire, which we'll talk about that when I get to that point. So, all right.
So just like on the other walls, square.
section here. It's going to be a little tricky because our 12 foot mark.
Oops. Here.
So, because we're doing 36s, we're going to run into a problem here because this is our 12. And we're going to have only, just the 1 foot here. But what I want to do is I want to have a door right here so you can get in and out of the coop. Okay? So that one here is at 9. So I'll probably come here and do... That actually looks like a pretty good spot there. It'll give us 2 feet, 2 foot 4 is 24. So 12 and 12. So that's 28 inches wide. And that's good enough for a door. So what we're going to do there is we're going to put one here at 28. And then we'll put our finished one here right at the end. Okay. I'm gonna give it enough support plus a room for a door. Like before, you put your pencil on your mark, slide your speed square into it, so that you're not off.
Okay, so I got the other one cut. Now I just want to point something out here. I have a joint right here between two studs, right?
Now, if we were building a house or a chicken coop or something else where you were going to nail these into the structure, then this kind of thing doesn't matter so much. You just do the two separate pieces as two separate walls. You just lift them up and nail them down. But where this bottom piece is actually going to sit in the dirt, I'm going to put just a little spacer on top of that. And help hold it all together. So, we're just going to avoid that. Spaces,
we'll have plenty of room. We'll be able to do the chicken wire in 36 inch wide pieces, so we'll be able to pull it nice and tight. And then down here at the end, this extra gap here, we'll be able to frame in a little door so that we'll be able to get in and out of the coop. Now, the coop's only going to be 5 feet. Well, these, I guess it'll be 5'3" when you count the top and bottom plate. So it'll still be, you'll still have to kind of duck walking around in there if you're taller than that, but as for how often you're actually going to be in there, that's not a big deal. For the most part, it's just providing extra room for the chickens to be able to move around if they're more comfortable. Okay, just a quick note on this stuff. This is the netting, the wire that I'm using. When you go to the hardware store, Home Depot or Lowe's or wherever it is that you prefer, you can buy what's called poultry netting, and it's basically this exact stuff. It's the same. You can get it. These are 1 inch. It's the 1 inch openings.
These are 1-inch openings, and as you can see, it's just it's 36 inches wide, and I don't know how many feet it was. But anyway, you can buy this as poultry netting, and it's kind of expensive. It's like $50 or something like that for like 25 feet or some ridiculous thing like that. But if you go like two aisles over to where the Stucco and Lath stuff is, you can buy this exact thing. This is just Stucco wire that you'd use for doing Stucco on your house. That's a Southwest thing, so I don't know if you're watching this video and you're up Northeast, I don't know if you're going to be able to find this as easily, but around here we do a lot of Stucco on our houses, so it's a foam board covered with this that you then put, it's a kind of like a cement, like a grout almost, that you smear into the wire and then you paint over it, and it's called Stucco. Anyway, this is the lad wire for that. It's the exact same thing, but it's like a fraction of the cost. Like this whole roll is probably only like $25 or $30. So just kind of be aware that there's more than one source for this, 1-inch diameter wire netting. Okay, so I'm making the door on this side. So I've cut my pieces just to fit fairly on the inside of that. I've got a little bit of play between them. I'm gonna do one support piece right in the middle so I can place for the latch. But other than that, it really doesn't need much more in the way of support for that. So 22.5 for that. Okay, now just a little quick tip. If you have to find the center of your line, let's see if we can move this over here and get a little better light. If you look at your tape measure, in this case,
We're at 57. And we need to find the center of 57. Well, if you're super good with math, maybe you just know that off the top of your head. But if you flip your tape measure around and put your start at 57, then the middle, right there, you can see that this is where we're at. So that's 28 and a half. So if you do 28 and a half, you can see the middle there. You can try to get a good angle of that. There, see?
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, 28 and a half.
So then that's where we're gonna put this middle board.
Again, we want to go 3/4 on both sides.
First grade.
And I'll put the little latch on there.
One of the things you can do when you're doing these walls like this is you can actually leave about a foot of extra chicken wire on the bottom, and then when you go to put your wall in place, you basically just dig down and then place the chicken wire on the ground, essentially under, you know, coming out away from the wall, and then you bury it. And what that does is, if you've got any kind of predator in the area, bobcat or a coyote or whatever, then when they try to dig under the wall to get to the chickens, they'll get caught up in that net. And usually if it's, you know, a foot worth of the chicken wire coming out off the bottom, it'll be a sufficient deterrent for any type of predatory animal. They won't usually continue once they get hung up in the chicken wire. So just kind of a note, if you decide to do this, if you're in an area where that's a possibility, then you might want to take that extra precaution. Where I live, that's not really going to be an issue. So as you can see, I'm just cutting it off right at the bottom. Anyway, just wanted to throw that out there in case you, if you're building this and you're in an area where there are predators. Okay, so this is the probably the final video for this chicken coop. So what I did is I basically just built another wall and then put it right up on top and then anchored it to the wall in the back, just using a couple of, just drilled the hole with a cement drill bit and then put it in there, and then I just put this tarp over top of it to create some extra shade, and that's pretty much it. You can see it's overlaps the roof a little bit. You can kind of see that. That's pretty much it. Got to clean up, obviously, get rid of all the old coop pieces. But that'll give them a lot more space, and there's a lot easier access now. So I can get in there and clean up as needed and change the food and water easily. I'll probably build a better water feeder and food dispenser so I don't have to refill it every day. But I'm going to run into issues with the heat, so I'll probably build a swamp cooler that I can just blow cold air into the coop, keep them happy. So anyway, that's the update for now. I'll do a few little tweaks here and there to just kind of secure it, but that's pretty much it. I just jammed a bunch of extra wire down in there to keep them from coming out that way. But that's pretty much it so far. So I've got the roost in there, and that's where they sleep on that. And then just the nest boxes. I only really need one, but I have a couple. My high-tech latching system. Why make it harder than it has to be?